Pope Francis is visiting the United States and people are excited. But what if science is your religion? How should you feel about Papa Francis? Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into DNews today. I'm Trace. In the 1950s, Pope Pius XII wrote that he hoped evolution would prove to be a passing fad, but that it doesn't contradict with faith as long as ensouling of humans was left to God. Pope John Paul II said in a 1982 book that evolution was an effectively proven fact. And more recently, Pope Francis said that God isn't a magician and creation lasted millions of years while the evolutionary process played out. And yet, a 2014 Gallup poll found 42% of Americans believe that the world was magically created in 7 days and that we hold dominion to destroy it as we wish. This kind of makes you wonder what religious leaders are really teaching us about science. The Catholic Church has long been party to the scientific community. In the mid-1700s, Pope Benedict XIV formed academies of science, art, and religion. And the Big Bang was originally proposed by George Lemaître, a Belgian cosmologist and Catholic priest. Some religious people are definitely science bros. More recently, Pope John Paul II wrote in a letter to the Vatican Observatory, a church-run telescope dedicated to astronomical research, science can purify religion from error and superstition, that molecular biologists have probed the structure of living material, showing the unity of nature. And with this in mind, simple neutrality is no longer acceptable. Keeping religion and science exclusive from one another fosters a fragmented vision of the world. JP2 was all, science or religion need to be bros. And that was back in 1988. Religious institutions have spent centuries trying to learn more about God's creation through science. Even celebrated scientist Galileo Galilei was offered a place in the Pontifical Academy of Science back in 1610. Of course, the Roman Inquisition later imprisoned him for attempting to reinterpret the Bible, but good times come and go for both science and religion. Before joining the Catholic establishment at 32, Pope Francis was called Jorge Mario Bergoglio, and he was much like you or me. He worked as a bouncer in a nightclub and went to a technical school in Buenos Aires, graduating with something akin to an associate's degree as a chemical technician. Pope Francis is down with science too. Earlier this year, Pope Francis issued a 98-page plea to all the bishops of the Roman Catholic Church to stop climate destruction. He commented that Christians should care for the environment and admitted that humans affected our changing climate, saying most global warming in recent decades is due to the great concentration of greenhouse gases. But that wasn't the first time he made a huge splash in the political and scientific communities. In 2014, Pope Francis said in a conversation with the Pontifical Academy of Sciences, "Evolution in nature is not inconsistent with the notion of creation, because evolution requires the creation of beings that evolve." He went on to say there is evidence for evolution and that it is a reality that we must see and which enriches our understanding of life. He also remarked that the Big Bang is considered to be the origin of the world. He was clear when he said these ideas are not contradictory to God or the teachings of the church. This is a pope, guys. When this happened, there were some collective heads exploding across the spacious skies, amber waves of grain, and on the purple mountains majesties, because a select group of Americans have long rallied against these exact messages. And yet, here's a religious leader acknowledging and accepting them. Perhaps the surprise that a pope would come out in favor of science is exacerbated by the fact that only 20% of people in a 2013 Pew study knew that nitrogen was the most abundant gas in our atmosphere, and only 58% knew that CO2 causes rising temperatures. Perhaps it's because Americans just don't science good. Despite his more progressive views on climate change and evolution, Pope Francis's alignment with the church on contraception, expanding roles for women, and allowing priests to marry, that hasn't budged. So whether Pope Francis is the most scientific pope is a solid maybe. Yes, things have changed in the last century, but the church has definitely been scientifically friendly for a few hundred years. Instead, I think, as we've become a more polarized culture, we're simply more surprised to hear agreement with scientific facts from such a powerful religious leader. His outspoken views on science aren't the only things that make Pope Francis stand out. For more on what makes this pope different from the others, check out this video that I did over on Test Tube News. While most popes have been relatively conservative and followed strict religious doctrine, Pope Francis has been modern, progressive, and socially conscious. So how has Pope Francis changed Catholicism? Also, check out the Science and Religion section of Test Tube Plus, our new podcast science show. We take 5 episodes and look at how science and religion can be friends. It's nice. Check that out too. There are people that would call this the war on science. I don't know how I feel about that term, but it is a term that's thrown around. Science has a war on it.
Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Make sure you subscribe. Keep coming back here every day for more science.